Well, I'm salty too. We're just a group of women up here who are real salty today. After our mother spoke on last night, we don't have to go through all the things about salt. We just need to know that we love the Lord and the Lord loves us. There is a distinctiveness about salt that we all need to know and carry in us because God has made us and created us. We know that salt is different from pepper, and so we as Christians should be different from the world. We don't walk like the world, we don't talk like the world, and we don't look like the world. The distinctiveness about us is that we're unique. We are unique because God created us. We're different. We are really different. We act different. It's just like the distinctiveness in business. In business, it's called marketing. In advertising, it's called positioning. In basketball, it's called strategy. In Christians, it's called holiness. I'm a holy woman. Walking and talking in holiness. I just want to share a little bit of my testimony because Mother has so adequately talked about salt. And you know, years ago, before I had a few birthdays, I would always sprinkle a little salt on just about everything I ate. But I've had some birthdays, and so I've learned that I cannot use as much salt as I did back then. I'm using it with caution. But listen at this. God has been so good to us, and one of the things that the devil wants to do is cause us to doubt our faith in God. The devil wants us to throw in the towel. He wants us to give up. So he's throwing everything at us that he can. And some of us are catching it, but what we must remember to do is when he tosses it to us, we've got to throw it back at it. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Let me share something with you. You know, most of you know, or many of you know, that in 2010, my husband died suddenly after a mission trip to Africa. And then after a few years, there was some time trying to get myself back together and believe that the ministry, the call that God had called me to help be salt in the earth. The enemy tried to take that from me, but I kept fighting because I know prayer is one of the preservatives in making it in life. It will help you to keep going if you stay prayerful. My mom is a dynamic prayer warrior. She'll be 94 in a few months, and I watched my mother pray. I heard my mother pray. So prayer was always important to me because I always said I wanted the DNA of my mom. I wanted to be a prayer warrior like my mom. Little did I know, the more you pray, the crazier the devil will get, because he hates prayer warriors. He hates intercessors. And after I thought I had built some resilience after my husband's death, last year it was 7 years ago, and things were going pretty good. I had accepted my new normal of being a widowed woman. I lost my son right in my house. Suddenly, he died suddenly. And you know, the devil tried to kick me. I was devastated. I thought, oh no, not my wonderful son, but thank God he was saved. My husband was saved. So I learned how to praise God because they got out of here saved. And that's what I'm living for, is to get out of here saved. So I thought that, God, I don't know how I'm going to handle this, but you brought me through once, and you're going to do it again. My sister came from Atlanta, Georgia, stayed with me 2 weeks, and I said, God, I thank you. She said, I think you're going to make it. You're going to do well. I went home. She went back to Atlanta. When she arrived at her home, she found her husband dead in the house. My God, the devil was wreaking all kind of havoc. I said, but devil, I know you. I'm not ignorant of your devices. I know you want us to give up, but we refuse to give up. Because my mother told me, I watched her as an intercessor. And I learned that whenever I thought of the scriptures that says, Lord, whenever my heart is overwhelmed, lead me to a rock that's higher than I. So I had to go to the rock, and his name was Jesus. I began to cry out to him because I know if I went to God, he was going to work things out. The devil said, oh yeah, you're going to lose your mind. Uh-huh. You can do all the talk you want to. I'm going to dry up this ministry that you have. I said, you're a lying wonder, because I love God too much. I remember, Mother Rivers, the time I watched my mother intercede. And you know, in old church, we taught the women, when they're going through things, how to go to God. We taught them how to pray. We taught them how to mourn. You know, Romans 8 says, likewise, the Lord wants to, when we're in our infirmities, when we're going through, God will help us. And I remember when my mother couldn't pray, she didn't have the words to say. She knew how to mourn and groan in the spirit. Because we knew the devil didn't understand the mourning and the groaning. But we don't teach our young women that anymore. We don't teach them how to travail. We don't teach them how to intercede. And I began to walk through my house. I didn't have the words to say. So I said, oh, Jesus. Woo. I said, oh. The more I called him, the more I called him, the more I mourned, and I just groaned. My God, the presence of the Lord came in, and it lifted my spirit. And I say to you today, the reason why I'm standing here, now I know God favored me. He didn't allow the enemy to triumph over me. Now I know God favored me. He didn't allow the enemy to triumph over me. Oh, 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 oh me. Oh, over me. God didn't allow the enemy to triumph over me. One last time. Oh, oh. God's not going to allow the enemy to triumph over you. He wouldn't allow the enemy to triumph over you.